Hey guys, Dave Keller here with Market Misbehavior. Wanted to talk about the challenges and the benefits of facing adversity. It's fall, it's football season, so I hesitate to use an overused sports analogy potentially, but I'm a lifelong Cleveland Browns fan, which has been a tough life. And this weekend we face the New England Patriots, who are the team obviously from where I used to live in the Boston area. So I have a lot of friends on social media and elsewhere that are raging Patriots fans, and we had a lot of nice banter leading up to the game, a lot of painful banter afterwards for me, because we gave up 17 points in the first quarter, went on to do pretty well the other three quarters, but it was too much of a hole to dig out of. And as with most things in life, I found myself trying to draw some lessons to investing and personal development from this painful football experience. What's funny is the Cleveland Browns are a very young football team, right? So they're very talented, but pretty untested, very green. And so the first quarter was a lot of sloppy turnovers, bad decisions, rampant penalties, just shooting themselves in the foot, continue to make just rookie mistakes that made it so hard to do well, made it so hard to compete against the other team because you're just competing against yourself the whole time. There are a lot of parallels to that and being a rookie investor or being an amateur or a newbie investor and how you get comfortable with it, right? And you tend to make poor decisions. You tend to have sloppy turnovers, meaning you're, you know, just making simple mistakes. You have rampant penalties in the fact that you are not setting yourself up. You're not going through the routines in a way that are setting yourself up for success. You're setting yourself up for hurting yourself by just not having good routines, not having good dedication and good discipline. You know, it's funny, if you read any good book from a famous investor, it always has a story of significant loss, climactic loss even, right? Usually earlier in the career, there was some experience, some moment, some week, some time period where they just were completely wrong, made big mistakes, lost a lot of money, and then a lot of the future self was driven by those early painful experiences. So how do you take advantage of those painful experiences as an investor? Well, number one, I would say be mentally prepared for them, right? You have to be prepared as an investor to face losses and to face adversity and to face market conditions that will not play out or not support your positioning or your thesis. That is a fact of it. So you have to expect it. And again, be mentally prepared for the fact that that's going to happen and not have it be an emotional experience, but have it be an experience that is driven by rules, is driven by evidence, and is driven by discipline. But how do you actually learn good lessons from those painful experiences? And I would say the most important thing I can suggest to you this week is a post-mortem analysis. Now, if you've ever done anything with someone in the technology field, at the end of a big project, they'll often do a post-mortem meeting. And that's Latin for after death. So essentially, you will review what happened during the project, look at what went well, what went poorly, what could we improve on, what should we do more of, what should we do less of. And the goal is to take all the lessons you can from that experience and then implement it for future experiences. So you're trying to always upgrade your process. And again, as investors, we need to do similar things. It's funny with the football team, right? The Browns ended up losing this game to the Patriots. So what do they do afterwards? They don't just move on to the next team. They're in the film room, right? They're watching film. They're trying to analyze what happened. The coach is trying to, you know, help the players understand where they could be doing better. What could they do better in the weight room? How could they do better on the practice field? How could they do better on their own, do better as a team? And as investors, we can be doing a lot of those same things. So a good post-mortem analysis is an honest review of some of your decisions. It could be just one big loss, especially after a period of significant losses. Great to take a hit pause, take a step back, and actually review. All right, here is a situation. Here is the evidence. Here are the steps that took me to that decision. Here's where I should have recognized it was wrong and I didn't. Here's what happened, you know, and try to understand, was it your toolkit that was just underwhelming, unprepared? Are there things that you missed, pieces of evidence that should be part of your process now? Was there extraneous information that you paid attention to that you shouldn't have? But a good postmortem is an honest review of a set of experience, set of decisions, and then an honest review of what drove those decisions and how you can, the goal is to have honest, specific takeaways that you can implement for future decisions. So my challenge for you this week is to do a postmortem analysis on some period, ideally a painful period, whether it's a recent bad trade, bad investment decision, when the market went against what you thought, where something different happened, and really break it down. How did you analyze it? How did you come to your decisions? Is there anything else that was going on that could have helped you avoid the bad decision? Is there anything that you can take from that and apply to your future routines to try to implement some better decision making? If this thinking of investment process and decision making routines is of interest to you, I hope you'll hit subscribe. Check out some of the other videos on the Market Misbehavior channel. Thanks so much.